Welcome back. Even with financial support from government, a school in Buyende district in eastern Uganda is beating the odds of operating with a hut for the administration block and a single classroom that makes up the whole school. It is among the many schools that hardly register distinctions in PLE. On Bistrons today, we look at capitation grants, funds offered by government to schools to replace tuition fees.
Buyende district in eastern Uganda, where a first grade from the primary living examinations is a miracle. And that miracle has not happened for a long time, especially for this school, Igalaza Primary School. These are the candidates from different schools around Buyende district that don't have Uganda National Exam Board center numbers. Four schools are writing their final exams here at Igalaza Primary School.
The school has formerly has a staff range of 20. But when the children went on decreasing, the staff range also went down. It is supposed to be 16, but we are now 12. But this one being a new district, when you ask for teachers, they say they are nowhere to be seen. Until the government gives, this time gives, that this district is supposed to have the number of teachers. But as it says, that the number of teachers are likely to be like this. Others leave. So other teachers have left.
Because of?
Poor payments. They say poor payments. And they leave when they have got loans whereby they cannot even be deleted.
But this school also doesn't have enough facilities to go through the exam period hosting three schools.
That one we have allowed it because we had an alternative. But looking at the distance that is recommended by UNEB, we agreed that they should sit like that instead of sitting on the floor.
Another school that has its candidates sitting exams from here is Igalaza SDA Primary School in Bukutula Parish, about 5 kilometers from here.
It was started in 2002 as a church-founded school, and by 2010, the government took it as started giving it aid. We have 447 pupils. Yeah, 221 are girls. 126 are boys.
This hut is the administration block that houses the headmaster's office, staff room, and store. In the event of UPE, capitation grants were introduced in 1997. Funds were offered by the government to schools to replace tuition fees. Every pupil is paid for 7,560 shillings per year. With a total of 763 pupils, the last capitation grants received does not equal the standard amount. Igalaza Primary School has received 1,640,000 shillings for the last time, but when calculated, it is 2,149 shillings per pupil. It has to be paid thrice, but still would amount to 6,448 shillings.
The 150 I'm talking about is the threshold. An irreducible minimum, which eventually comes to 450 for the 3 months. So, if the number of students are bigger and more than what the 450,000 should have covered, then that variation that we just talked about is what's distributed per head, per child in those schools. Because there will be schools that are even smaller than what the 450 should cover, and there are those that are much bigger. So those that are bigger, you'll find that that money that is required to do so will be got from those other schools where the threshold is sufficiently covering or is even more than what is required. The main measure that is in place by government is to ensure that there is a work plan laid down by the schools. The schools will come up with a work plan work plan is approved, money is sent, and then the ministry will send monitoring teams. There are district education officers in the various districts, there are school inspectors, there are mechanisms by school inspectors.
Like the Ministry of Education and Sports clearly stipulates, it is the responsibility of parents to provide food, uniform and moral support for their children. At Igalaza Primary School, a support fee of 7,000 shillings is charged per term, but the villagers here find it very expensive. They pay in installments. Jennifer Naikoba is a mother of seven. Some of her younger children go to this school.
The problem is that business is not moving well. But I would like all my children to go to school, and they all want to. Right now, one is in senior three, but the situation is not good. There's another one in primary seven, and I wonder how I'm going to afford her fees. I have another one who completed senior four, but he's just at home because I have no means of catering for his advanced level.
The school could use more than the 7,000 shilling supplement. Maize is contributed to the school as an obligation used to make meals for the pupils. As these people sit for their exams, the headmaster is almost sure there will be no first grade from any of them. This is perhaps the most costly consequence of free education for all since 1997. In 1999, the number of primary school enrollment had gone up to 6 million, and that number continues to rise. The big question, however, is where the poor performing primary school graduates will end up. Can government keep up capitation grants and make it more sustainable, especially for rural schools?
Time to look at the good and bad stories of the day, those that either get a thumbs up or thumbs down. Here's our wacky and dope. The wacky goes to poor funding for UPE school that's affecting the academic performance of pupils, and the dope for today is to those graduating starting tomorrow at MAK University. I guess congratulations are in order.
Streets is watching.
You are watching PM Live.
For Connect today, we've been asking, do you think going to a public or private university really matters? Your yes or no, and reasons why. Now let's listen to your views coming in from the hashtag PM Live via our social media pages. That's it for today's show. Thank you so much for being a part of it. Now, if you haven't seen the announcement online yet, we are welcoming those of you who are looking at starting careers in TV journalism. Tweet at me directly for details. That's at Raz Athman. Use the hashtag PM Live. Until tomorrow, stay blessed.
PM Live is brought to you by
Global Institute of Information Technology and Business Makerere.